described the moments as an officer shot a suspect while the suspect sped down the road in a car with the officer inside the entire time. Police say the incident started as a narcotics investigation last night and ended in a three-car crash in the 1000 block of Clay Street. WDSU News reporter Blake Hansen says the incident all unfolded in a matter of seconds.
Trash cans.
Around 9 Tuesday night, Gary Forsyth stepped out of his Clay Street home to a wild scene.
What the hell was all that noise?
As Forsyth revisited the area with us, there were still signs of the situation police say could have ended far worse.
Next thing I could hear, somebody was going, "We got him, we got him, we got him."
Kenner police say the incident began as part of a narcotics investigation. Two narcotics officers approached two suspects sitting reclined in a Honda Accord in the parking lot of this Brothers. But the driver didn't want to cooperate with police.
When he did put it in reverse, the officer, the narcotics agent, fell inside the vehicle on top of the passenger as the driver fled from the scene.
What happened next all unfolded in seconds. Police say the driver of the car sped down Clay Street with the officer still inside, hitting trash cans along the way. His gun already drawn, the officer inside shot the 31-year-old driver, Eldrin Smart, 4 times, killing him almost instantly. The car then collided with two empty cars near the corner of a church parking lot. These pictures showing the aftermath. With the driver dead, the passenger and officer were injured, and the passenger gave up.
I think the passenger may very well have been as shocked as the officer was as he was pulled into the vehicle when the suspect drove off.
Police say Smart has been jailed 22 times with a lengthy criminal and drug history. A resident of Lutcher, he was on parole until 2018. Caraway says a recent rise in violent crime in Kenner can be tied to drugs.
The nexus to it, I believe, is the drug connection.
Back on Clay Street Wednesday, neighbors tried to return to life as normal.
Went ahead of my routine and let the police take care of what was down here.
Walked my dog right there in front of the house, and it's like I was out earlier with them.
Wondering what would have happened at a different time, or if the pursuit had it ended so quickly. In Kenner, Blake Hansen, WDSU News.
Kenner police say the officer who was injured was released from the hospital and put on administrative leave. That is protocol anytime after an officer has fired a weapon.